watch and listen to this. Please watch and listen. Do not forget to share after watching. Watch and listen. A Cameroonian has become a DRC Congo second coronavirus patient. Health authorities in DRC Congo have confirmed that the second person tested positive is a 46-year-old Cameroonian who lived in DRC Congo with his family. According to BBC, he returned from France on the 8th of March but did not show symptoms of the virus. Cissé Kouyaté Thabé set new conditions to resolve the Anglophone crisis in the Northwest and the South regions, which has been battling the two regions for close to 4 years now. At least 8 boys fighting for restoration are said to have resigned from competing in Akosa Division Duga Mountain Division in the Northwest regions. One of the commanders of a boy called Trimby Ali said is said to have championed the process last week for the sake of peace. The boys that have been fighting the bush were received at the entrance to Akko, turned by security forces and other local officials. A resident says some newly elected councillors of Akko Council facilitated the process of letting the boys lay their arms. In the urban buses that left the town of Bamenda for other major cities like Douala, Yaoundé are currently stuck at Babujo. This is due to the slippery state of the roads. The road is said is bad and muddy. Cars can cross the area. The rainfall in this area certainly made matter worse, one of the stranded passengers says. CRM activists in prison in Bagante, the West Region Court, rejects their request for provisional release. The Court of First Instance of City decided during the hearing on Thursday, March 12, to keep them in prison. They had hoped for a favorable response from the Court of First Instance in Bagante following their request for provisional release. But Rosanna Rassi, Jamelo Redburn, Jan Foga, and Jan Marine Chemta, all the activists of Communism Party, were dismissed by the court during the hearing on Thursday. The judge rejected the request for provisional release, then rejected the objection to nullity of procedure as unfounded, reports one of the defendant lawyer. Two students below 10 years attempted to assassinate their teacher in Betwa. The SDO Fongo Kitunja Division, the West Region Kwente Adesun Kone, has condemned what qualifies as a barbaric act committed by separatist bandits against civilians' population. The alleged inhumane incidents, which according to SDO occurred March 10 in Babese, was made public Thursday, March 12 on the state media. Four persons, including the former SDF mayor, unspeakably killed by a separatist gang. The victim were hostage for a few hours by defense and security forces. The former SDF mayor accused for relaying information about activities of the separatist fighters was murdered at his home. The population and secessionist group claimed to protect our victims of their atrocities, explained the STO. It's past 10 p.m. hours after Boya was stopped to have electricity, according to the load shedding plans of electricity distributed company New. This, however, not the case, as New has failed to respect its own load shedding schedule since it was put up, leaving locals to restore alternative means of power. Cameroonian Minister of Territorial Administration says terrorists that carry out attack in Galim West regions will not go caught free. Boalak Tanganji used his visit to Galim today to restate his stance of shutting down NGOs and human rights groups that undermine the activities of the military. Yesterday, shock over the death of a woman in Ndou. Ngwafak Adama is the name of the woman whose body was found laying on the road in Ndou, Nuga Mountain Division of the Northwest Region. Divergent views accompany the widespread picture of her body. Investigation said she was killed by a stray bullet. Adama was spotted heading to farm when she was shot. Pictures have also been emerged showing soldiers beside her body. Apparently, on the assessment mission, how Adama died and who responsible remain unknown. Security situation in the Northwest region of Cameroon has been deteriorating since after February 9, 2020 elections. The Minister of Territorial Administration, Paul Otanganji, is expected to chair a security meeting in Bamenda during his visit to the region yesterday. He visited the site where a locally made bomb exploded beside the grandstand on the 8th of March on Women's Day. US donation of 71 million francs to Cameroon to fight against coronavirus has been criticized by some opposition parties to this category of people. There's some diplomatically degraded Cameroon. They equally question why the US is quick to help in The ban of health by imposing economic sanctions on Cameroon as a result of human rights violations. Who will be the elected Speaker of Cameroon National Assembly? Kabal, Libby member of parliament from Peace and Party CC, has been receiving calls from Cameroonians for him to run on the top job at the legislative arm of the government. He added that at the right time he will give the option to try. His political party can trust 5 members of parliament, while the ruling CPTM party has over 139 pending election reruns. Commentators said it would be nearly impossible to win a candidate of the ruling party to hold. Minister Paul Atanganja has ordered committees in the West Region to create village vigilante groups to join the military fight against armed separatists. He was speaking in Galim Babutu's division of the North Region of the West Regions as he visited affected areas by armed attacks on Sunday. Ceremony to award the attribute to the Member of Parliament at the National Assembly of Cameroon has been postponed. The ceremony initiated bill from March the 13th, 2020, has been pushed to Monday, March the 16th, following a communique released by the Chair of the National Assembly. Abdullah Duda, in his release, did not state reasons for the last-minute postponement. The mayor of the city of Gongsamba and his deputy have been asked to bring Gongsamba back to its one-time place of biggest town in Cameroon. They challenged the Gongsamba Court of First Instance as they were being sworn in. Kenya Health Minister said an investigation is underway into an allegation that blood donated by Kenyan is being smuggled to Somalia. The ongoing investigation links a government agency to an illegal sale of blood. The regional governors announced it will quarantine visitors coming from China, Italy, South Korea, Iran as part of its measures to combat spread of coronavirus. These are some of the countries with the highest number of cases. Nigerian President Abdali Tubun has ordered schools to close throughout the countries in an attempt to prevent the spread of coronavirus. The closure started immediately and will continue until a brief fit. South African Minister of Health has reported that the country's first case of the local transmission of coronavirus, the 2-year-old man, has contracted coronavirus after coming in contact with a Chinese businessman. A 30-year-old girl with albinism is leading a campaign to make sure girls in Tanzania complete their school. Joyce Simeon says her parents wanted her to deliberately fail her exam so that she wouldn't continue her education. They feared her safety in school because she has albinism. A hospital in South Africa is investigating if a man does smuggle placentas out of a facility with a plan to sell them to traditional healers. The nurse was arrested by police who were on patrol after what they described as suspicious behavior. The United States has imposed sanctions on 2 senior Zimbabwean politicians over human rights abuses. U.S. Treasury of Department accused Secretary Minister Owen Nchube of ordering the abduction and the mistreatment of opposition supporters. The former commander of the Allied Army Unit, Anselm Samyatu, is accused of ordering troops to shoot protesters, including incidents in 2018 where 6 supporters of the MDC party were killed. Kenya reports its first new case of coronavirus in the area. Dollar from NGO inflows boosts Uganda shillings. Uganda arrests ex-security chief seeking to unseat president. President Trump banned travels from Europe, potential to limit domestic. China hints at denying America's life-saving coronavirus drugs. Every Russian regional parliament back changes, allowing Putin to extend rule. New Zealand adding late curse to treatment amid coronavirus curse. Russia take aim at US share price. Poland president call off Russian trip due to coronavirus. Officials US wage retaliatory airstrikes in Iraq following attack that killed 2 troops. Greece were first female president amid coronavirus crisis in the globe. Japan says Olympic on track as Abbott and Trump talks on coronavirus. Sudan economic crisis almost here after Bashar ousted. Sudan economy has sunk into crisis, says the overthrow of long-term autocrat Omar al-Bashir. Person having me travel to China soon, comment.